Now a day trip to an island off the North Shore. Ted Reinstein tells us the public hadn't been permitted on this island until recently.
It's been Salem's best kept secret, but now the word is out. Off limits for 70 years, Baker's Island is now open to visitors. The majority of this 60-acre island, 5 miles east of Salem Harbor, is still private, belonging to residents with summer homes here. But 3 years ago, the Coast Guard turned over the 10-acre light station property to the Essex National Heritage Commission.
It's a fabulous property. It's really beautiful. It's also very historic, and we're into the history of this region, and this is just such an interesting place to bring people.
Our two-hour trip begins at Hawthorne Cove Marina, where we meet our deckhand, Ryan McMahon.
This is our vessel. It's a 32-foot landing craft vessel built in Washington State. Baker's Island is the largest residential island north of Boston. Our organization owns 1/6 of the island. It's an old Coast Guard station.
The 30-minute boat ride to the island is half the fun, says McMahon, who points out sights along the way.
This is Winter Island Light right over here. When you come across the coast here, you come into Salem Willows, and then it cuts into Beverly, where you'll see Hospital Point Lighthouse, the square lighthouse right over there.
We also travel along Beverly's Gold Coast.
The Gold Coast of Beverly was a very important vacation spot in the late 1800s and early 1900s, and in fact, it was the summer White House for President Taft. So there's some beautiful old homes along there.
McMahon explains that trips to the island require the unconventional boat.
This is a landing craft boat, so we have no dock to access the island. So the front of the boat is going to drop down onto the beach. We crash right into the beach, and the front panel will drop down, and you storm the beach like from the boats from World War II. So welcome everyone to Baker's Island. We're going to walk down the path this way and hike our way up to the lighthouse. So you can see our beautiful beach. We actually have one thing here that we always tell everyone, so it's leave no trace behind. If you come to our island, anything you see, we ask you not to take. We want to leave the island exactly how we found it.
Signs on the island remind folks that many residents here fought the release of these 10 acres to the public.
There's 55 homes that are on the island. Most people that live on the island, the homes have been in their families for generations. I kind of understand their concern because there's no public roads. So I try to explain to people that the reason that they don't want people there, it's like if you went in your backyard and there were people on lounge chairs, they just want their privacy. And we very much respect that.
With no visitors for decades, the island remains pristine. The highlight, Baker's Island Light.
There's a history that goes all the way back to 1630s, and when this island was used to gather ballast for the ships and also wood for the masts. It was also a dangerous place to be because there's so many rocks and shoals around it. So in 1791, the Salem Marine Society first came out here and erected a day marker. And then pretty soon after that, they erected a light too to warn ships off of all the rocks around here.
On our visit, Bill and Brenda Simmons were the lighthouse keepers.
You go with the sun out here. You wake up when the sun comes up, which is about 5:30, and you stay till around 9:30, and by that time you're beat. And what we do is anything.
Simmons' favorite role was greeter and tour guide.
I was a park superintendent. I was a ranger for many years. I'm used to being outside. I'm used to dealing with people, and we enjoy giving back. It's part of our country's history.
The 19th century lighthouse was restored thanks to some 21st century fundraising.
We did a Kickstarter campaign and we raised more money than we expected, and we've been able to restore the whole exterior of the lighthouse. And it looks wonderful. I mean, she's really shiny and white, and the whole lantern building on top, the lantern room, is all redone.
Preserving local history and opening up a whole new part of Salem.
A lot of people that live around here, they've always boated around the island, and it was always a place that you couldn't go. So it's really nice that we were able as an organization to open it up to the public.
2 weeks until Baker's Island tours resume on June 16th. They run Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays this year. Plus a new feature this season, overnight stays on the island for Essex Heritage Voyage members. The cost, which includes the boat ride and an overnight stay for four people, is $350. And one more thing, lighthouse keepers Bill and Brenda Simmons, well, they stepped aside for a new couple taking over this year. When she gets hungry, she lets her hair down.
An emerging artist's emerging donut.